Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the REC Toycast, brought to you by REC Comics and Collectibles. I am your host, Roman Chavez, and with me, as always,
Eric Icarus.
Eric.
Yeah.
We have a new toy to review.
Yeah, we do. I didn't even know this was coming out. That's how unconscious I am, dude. You sent me a picture and I lost it.
I'm very excited. It literally just came in today, guys, so we had to say, let's do another toy review.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you so much for watching the last toy review, Marvel Select Psylocke. It's got a lot of views for us, and we hope that you like it. Definitely leave us some comments to, you know, let us know what we can do better. We're figuring this whole thing out. Even our setup here is a little jank, but super fun, all right? So right now, what you can see in front of you is the Marvel Legends Avengers Endgame Nano Gauntlet.
Yeah.
Very cool. They released an Infinity Gauntlet a few years, last year, and we'll show you a little side-by-side of that later. But yep, this bad boy just came in today. Very excited. It's got some very cool box, you know, art's not the right word, just like different ways that we can see
and pose the glove. It's pretty sick, man.
Yeah, it's very, very cool. So yeah, as you can see, that thing just busted open on me, but that's fine. Let's crack this bad boy
open.
Let's
do it, man. Let's do it. I'm already losing it. Can't contain myself.
Right off the bat, that's what it looks like on the inside. Very cool. It's got a little diagram, something like that, of the glove. Give that to my lovely assistant, Erica. Alright. Let's go ahead and grab that box. Alright. So there she is.
Oh my god.
The Nano Gauntlet. It's very cool. It's very, it's not, I don't want to say heavy, but it definitely feels very firm. As you can see, we have all the six stones. Inside, if you look in there, you can kind of see it's a little, got some, there we go, that's a good look. It's got these little levers you can pull, this little thing that goes around your hand that you can articulate the fist. Make it do terrible things, you naughty children. And yeah, what do you think of that, man?
I think that's, I'm speechless. That's why I'm not talking, because that's pretty sick, man.
Yeah, they're supposed to make noises, so we're going to have to open up some batteries, and we're going to get you guys a look at this thing in all of its glory. All right, guys, so we put in some batteries, and our resident hand model, Eric, is going to show you some cool features of the glove.
Yeah, man, this thing's got like a decent weight to it.
Yeah.
Like, surprisingly, doesn't feel like a cheap piece of plastic like I thought it was going to. It's just, look at that. This thing has just got detail for days, man. Like, I'm just stunned how much work they put into this, to be honest with you.
I could personally stand for the red to pop a little bit more, like a more metallic. It's
sure.
A little dull, not in a bad way.
No.
It's just a little, it's like, it feels like if it's Iron Man who made it, it would have a bright,
more sheen
red.
To
yeah,
it,
still
yeah.
But like more metallic.
Definitely. Dude, that's like real rubber.
On the grips there?
Yeah.
What about on these top ones? Are these plastic or these are, oh, those are rubber too.
What?
That is really neat.
Dude, that's a nice little touch. What?
If you touch that yellow stone there, the soul stone, go ahead and give it a...
What the... Oh my god, that is pretty sick, man.
Very cool, and already it has different sounds than the Infinity Gauntlet.
Cool.
Yeah. There you go.
Listen to that noise, man.
Does each one moves... You know, in its own right.
Oh, definitely. So we're gonna go index, middle, ring, pinky, thumb.
Yeah. Very cool. Oh, yeah. You don't want to take a punch from that.
Oh man. Oh, that is so sick, man.
It really does have a lot of different sounds. Okay.
And then I think there's a latch on here, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. So if you pull that latch there,
it stays closed. Or
give it that ring finger again. Sometimes on the Infinity Gauntlet, it was a little janky at times too.
Oh my goodness!
So if you push it up, there
you go. There we go. All staying right. In frame, and then boom.
Yeah.
You get that over.
That looks great.
Oh man.
God, I wish we would have had stuff like this when we were kids. The only thing that was comparable
we
to
We had
this,
imagination.
We had imagination. There would sometimes be these Halloween toys that came out that were like skeleton hands that had kind of independent
movie figures. Oh, I remember those, yeah.
And they were really cool, but they didn't, like, go over your existing hands. No. They, like, were an extension of your arm, so they looked really,
exactly.
Really
weird. Oh, man, this is beautiful, man. This is actually really cool. I'm not going to lie. I'm pretty impressed with this, man.
What's interesting about it, too, is that, you know, this idea all kind of stems from, you know, the Infinity Gauntlet series and the Soul Gems, or Soul Stones, as they were called initially. Yeah, the stones themselves show up in Marvel Premiere number 1 in 1972.
Okay.
They're known as the Soul Gems.
Just the all Soul Gems.
Yeah, just all Soul Gems. You know, took different writers later, you know, to kind of flesh out what they were going to be.
Totally.
And then we actually get the Infinity Gauntlet in 1990 in Silver Surfer Volume 3 number 44. And then we actually have the kind of comparison here. If you want to move that one, we can get this one in there. So this was last year's model. It's left-handed, like Thanos uses in the film. And this is kind of the more traditional Infinity Gauntlet. It actually looks a little different than it did in the comic books.
Yeah, a little bit. This is definitely more movie-based.
Definitely more movie-based.
Yeah.
And as you can see, it has all the same, pretty much all the same features. You know, it's articulate, the hand moves, the different locks noises. Happen. But it has different noises, which
cool.
I was concerned that they weren't going to do that. The detail on this is beautiful, too. I might even repaint these, because I really want them to pop. I want it to be very gold,
and
I want it to be very, like, metallic red.
Definitely.
But I think that they're just wonderful, wonderful pieces. And, I mean, something that any collector would just love.
Yeah, whether movie or comic book or both, you gotta have these, man.
You've got to.
And it's sick.
I mean, look at the comparison there in terms of what, you know, with the articulation, the size, like, it's obvious that Thanos and the Hulk would wear these.
Yeah.
And there you go. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's beautiful. Just both of them lit up like that. And actually, this Nano Gauntlet from the film, we actually see kind of a version of it in a Avengers Volume 4, number 12 from 2011.
Huh.
And we kind of see Tony Stark wear a version of this gauntlet, which was very cool.
Yeah, dude.
Which one's your favorite?
Iron Man's.
You like the Iron Man one better?
Oh, yeah, totally, dude.
I am an Infinity Gauntlet man through and through. So I really enjoy the classic. I am so happy that they are right-handed and left-handed.
I was about to say.
And I can't wait to put them on and just beat on you with them as best I can, all right?
All right, I'm gonna totally kind of ask you some nerd questions here.
Sure.
Because I don't remember from the movie. Okay, what's this one?
Oh, geez, that's going to be the Time Stone.
Time.
That'll be Power. That'll be the Space Stone. That is the...
Reality?
Reality Stone, yes. Let's see, this one's Soul. And then what is the orange one?
You're losing it, kids.
I know, man. We're old now. So time, space. Oh my gosh. What is it? Time, space, reality, mind, soul.
Yeah. So that's, I think this Mind Stone is in the middle. Because
that's the Mind Stone.
That's when you took from Vision.
Yeah.
So that's got to be soul. So mind, soul, ether.
Reality.
Reality.
A space.
Space.
Power.
Time.
Cool, we got them, kids. Woo! Can't put me on the spot like that. Can't put me on the spot like that, buddy.
That was my bad.
No, I love it. I love it. Well, kids.
Oh, man, that is just too cool, bro.
I think that's what we got for you guys today. If you like what we're doing, please hit that subscribe button. Give us a like. Give us a comment. We've gotten a few on that last one, so it was very, very nice. You know, apparently I have Sasquatch arms, and Eric doesn't really understand how to open up an action figure. All right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I have been your host, Roman Chavez.
Still Eric Icarus.
And we will catch you next time on the next Toycast review.